Hello, 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 hello. How y'all doing? I am Shay Rippinger of Hip the Hoopla here with the Hoopla Y'all Show. This is episode 90. Woohoo! And I'm so celebrating this. So, yeah, this is a very awesome thing. So, yes, 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 yes. And celebrating, oh, so many things. Shall we start? Okay, so welcome to the Hoop Love Y'all Show. If you're new here, hi, I'm Shay Rippinger. I'm a hooper, professional happiness coach. I'm a lot of things. And I'm here to share with you a little bit about health, humor, and hooping. So hooping, yeah, and health and humor. And the humor comes from my humorous demeanor throughout this. So yeah, I may laugh at myself quite a bit. Anyway, I want to say a special shout out to a few people who are all live right now. I was just going to wave to them real quick so that they may say hi. Hi, 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 hi. Yes. There we go. Okay. So hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you so much for being here. And so if I hear little beeps along the way, I'll try and check all the feeds and stuff like that. I'm on a two-camera setup here. I don't know if this will be the last of the shows from my little tiny office space, my little hallway office space, before I move it into my nice new space. The nice new space has been in the works for actually, several months now. But the last of it was supposed to take 3 days, and it's been like over a month. So anyway, I'm excited to move in there. It's not quite ready yet, but I shall have a video up of the beautiful blank space that is going to be my artistic creative business canvas. I'm very excited about that. So hi, Laura, Laurel, Akasha, yeah, Colby, Sheila, Agnes, Angela, yes, Anna, Billy, Kim, yes, hi everybody, hi. So, welcome, welcome, welcome. This is the Be Your Bliss series. Ooh, I'm so excited about this. We're very excited. So we're going to be talking about how to become more blissful in our lives. So, and we're going to be using the four B's. So this is going to be a four-part series of this month, and should be exciting. And I'm back to my normal schedules of just the Monday nights at 6:30 Mountain Standard Time. So, not foreseeing any, weird surprises that come up, but I will do my best. It is a live show, so anything could happen. Our construction crew might decide to show up today. It's like really late in the day. They should have been here this morning. I don't think they're coming at all, but anyway, surprises of life. Okay, so today is the because theme. So that's one of the four B's. So I'm going to give you a little sneak hint at the four B's. So because, begin, blah, blessings, and bliss. So those are going to be the four B's to the Be Your Bliss series. So, all right, I have a little bit of health. Let's see here. Yes. Why is this called because? Why is the theme of this particular show because? Because. That's from The Wizard. Da, 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 da. Yes, I think that's from The Wizard of Oz. Anyway. Because is the what's your why. First, before you find your bliss, you kind of need to know what your why is. Why are you doing whatever you're doing? So whether it's pursuing something or just waiting for something to fall at your feet, fall at your door, fall over your head. Hopefully you're not waiting for that. But anyway, what is your big why? Tiny story, because your reason why is going to be one of the reasons why you pursue your goals. So, and why you need to have a big why, because you're going to come across roadblocks and stumbles along the way. There are going to be times of self-sabotage moments. There's going to be times of resistance. And if you have a big enough why of why you want to do something, you can get over, under, through, around those obstacles. So that's one of those really helpful things to know is what's your big why? And the bigger your why, the more you'll stick to all the steps that you need to get to your goals, to finding your bliss. So, and your bliss is your path along your way too. So it's not just about this destination, I'll be happy when. It's more of a, I'm happy, you know, hopefully, and we'll be covering this in this series too, but I'll give you a little sneak preview, is that it's a journey and you need to enjoy the steps along the way. So one of my whys is to cut out sugar. So, or one of my, yes, my big reasons why cut out sugar. I had gone through cancer before. It was skin cancer. One of the reasons why is that sugar helps break down the immune system. It helps the immune system not function to its optimal potential. So if you're dealing with anything, any kind of healthcare crisis, even mental stuff too, because like, let's say you have brain fog or you're just not as sharp as you want to be, give this a shot. This is my personal journey on this one, but giving up sugar, I had issues with candida, and that's where your gut produces extra candida. We all have candida in our gut, in our natural biome, in our, you know, intestines. But sometimes the candida runs rampant. So it gets to be too much. It's too much of an overload, and your body, it's, you know, and anytime you have too much of a thing, not good, right? So one of the reasons why I cut out sugar, it there was so many problems that were plaguing me. And this sugar crisis type of thing of trying to get rid of it has, I've had ebbs and flows and spirals around and coming back to the beginning of, you know, having to do it all over again. You know, I remember when I first started this journey and I was cutting out sugar, and my husband's like, when do you get back to eating, you know, when do you get back to eating normal? And one of the things I had to learn along my personal journey was that I had to create a new normal, which was a lot less sugar. And at first, to get rid of the candida, to lessen its stronghold on my body, which was taking me out in so many immune system ways. Itchy skin, psoriasis, eczema, all sorts of stuff. And the candida is a precursor for cancer too. So anyway, but yeah, taking that sugar out was a rough journey. And I had several goes at it. It's kind of like vegetarianism, where I've been, you know, way better at it and not so great at it. And then, you know, I get, you know, it's kind of like running up a hill. Sometimes you have the energy to make it up, and sometimes you slide back down. You're like, you know, I need to get back to base camp over here, because it's comfortable back here. It's comfortable to do the known thing, but that might be a place that wasn't all that good for you. So, just because it's not a life or death situation doesn't mean it shouldn't get changed. But in my case, it was becoming my why became so big of the problems that I was having from the healthcare standpoint, that cutting out sugar became a much easier thing because I had a really, really, really strong why. At first, when I first discovered this, I had itches that wouldn't go away. And I like literally spent 3 months pretty much inside, not seeing anybody, not socializing. And I got very bummed out about it, to say the least. And I was at wit's end. And then somebody told me to go get a blood check. I got my candida checked at a place in Colorado called the Green Herb. And it's not a dispensary, but they just do herbal remedies, regular herbal remedies and things like that. So I found out that I had candida, and they took like a little prick of my blood, live blood sample, put it on a little slide, and put it on a magnifying a microscope that with a large TV, and you could see the cells like moving around. And I got a consultation from them and everything of like what this is, what all the different things are, what they're doing, why there's a lot of these and not a lot of those, and why there should be more of these and not those, and all kinds of things. So I chose to take a pretty extreme approach to hit this out. And I went through the cupboards. I got rid of a lot of the sugar. I got rid of a lot of the gluten. And there was all kinds of things that went into it, a lot of processed foods. And interestingly enough, it was just healthy eating that I was left with. So, you know, like I still consider veggies free reign. So as long as you're not covering them with sauce and butter and, you know, or, you know, just processed stuff, and you're eating like lots of veggie, you can eat as many as you want. You know, potato chips are not like a veggie serving. So just FYI. So, but good raw or lightly cooked, lightly steamed vegetables, that became like one of my safe foods, my go-tos. And as a result, I ended up changing my palate around on this. And so I actually like a lot of those things. It took me a long time to get to the place that I'm at. So it was like baby steps to get to all of these things. So one of the reasons why I tell you this story is because I have a health recommendation, because then this one's a fun one. So I wasn't a huge soda drinker before. I enjoyed some stuff, you know, like when I went to the movies theater, I enjoyed like candy and a cherry Coke. And that was like my movie food. And I really enjoyed that because I really enjoyed going to movies or watching a movie at home. And that was really fun for me. So that became my like thought pattern of like what felt good, tasted good to me. Well, I ended up finding something that is really awesome. Me and my husband discovered it, and it's Zevia. And so I'm not a spokesperson or anything like that. But this one happens to be my favorite one, and it's cherry cola. And if I'm not mistaken, this one does contain a little caffeine, but it's really minor. So anyway, yes, and it's naturally flavored and is zero calories. So, and zero calories without using crap like aspartame. So aspartame is a really bad substance that can help give you migraines and all kinds of just nasty stuff. If you are drinking diet sodas, please try this. Please try this. Try water, try tea, try anything else. Try caffeine free if you possibly can. I like this because it's a nice light soda. It's very tasty. They have lots of flavors. This just happens to be my favorite one. So Zevia, it's a fun one. So anyway, that my why, because of the non-sugar thing, that became something that was really good. And it's flavored with, why it's called Zevia is because it's flavored with stevia. And stevia is a natural sweetener that comes from a plant. And especially if you get it in its very raw form, like literally the green form where it's just ground up leaves into a powder, then there's no processing to that whatsoever other than just pummeling the leaves and doing that. And you can grow stevia yourself and do the same darn thing. So it can be very economical, and it's healthy, and it's 100 times sweeter than sugar. So I learned this back when we used to have our health food store in Nature's Garden back in the day. And that was a really mind-blowing thing to me, was stevia. And now stevia, you can find it everywhere in lots of things. So do watch how much it's processed. So be careful on that. But anyway, this is a good kind of sort of guilty pleasure, but you know, you're not getting like 200 calories of sugar calories, of empty calories that have no nutritional value. If you're going to have not any nutritional value, you might as well have like the healthiest version of something. So this is a treat for me. It's not like, you know, I drink it every day and all that stuff, but it's a nice treat. So again, I love my movies, and that's kind of fun to have along with my movies. I also make a lovely healthy popcorn. Okay, dogs are going to be barking, so that might be a little noisy in the background. Okay, so I want to get to the humor portion, which is going to be a live Shiva. Sorry about that. Which is a live laughter yoga exercise. So what we're going to do is, this is about finding your why. So this is, you're going to take a nice deep breath in, and we're going to do a shoulder shrug. Like, you know, when somebody goes, why'd you do that? And you're like, why? Why? So you're going to take a nice deep inhale in when we bring this in, and bring the shoulders up, and then we're going to laugh it out. And this is the I got this laughter. So we're going to bring this in again, inhale it in, and why? And then laugh it out. And do this with me. We'll do one more breath. Take it in, inhale in, and then exhale it out. the I got this breath. So after laughter yoga exercises, we take our hands together. We do this twice. So do this with me, please. We go very good, yay. Very good, yay. So that's our fun little laughter yoga exercise for this episode for today. And I want to show you a little hoopy move real quick. And I think I'm doing okay on time. And also, I wanted to do a special shout out to my dad. It's his birthday today. Happy birthday also to Coco. And thank you to everybody that helped with World Hoop Day and did the dance and all that kind of good stuff. So there's still time to get in your video if you're watching this before the deadline. And you can do all of that. So I'm going to give you a little hard thing. So the why, this is fitting in with the theme of the show, is the because. Is we're going to start with what's important to your heart. So you're going to bring, this is going to be a heart hinge fold. So you're just going to bring one hand into the chest, place it on the chest in between your chest and then sit in the center of your chest. So just above your heart. And so we're going to take the other hand and we're going to be moving the hoop around. So with this, this is a heart hinge fold, right? So you can do all kinds of things with this. This can go into another move. So this can go into a wrap where you take this around. That would be good if I had a larger hoop here, but and a larger space. But hey, you work with what you got. So you can take this either way. So either hand over the heart. And although the heart is kind of off center on the body, we're going to pretend like it's in the center of your chest. So the other hand is going to flip and fold. So you can take this and do like a little double move and twist with this. So there's lots of variations. It's a fairly simple move, but you can take this, go nice and slow with this. You can twist. You can take this as quick as you can. And you can take this at different, you can also take this at different parts of your body too of how to do a hinge fold. But I just wanted to show you that heart hinge fold as a cool little move that you can add to your repertoire. And it can be a fun transitional move of moving into the other things that you want to do. So, yeah. So have fun with that. Alrighty. I think that's pretty much everything I need to cover for tonight. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks for the hearts out. And I'm going to be waving to a couple people on here. Yes. And I'm going to check messages on. Yeah. Okay. Make sure I got everybody here. Say hi to everybody. Alrighty. Hi, Akasha. So thank you so much for watching. And tune in next week. We're going to be... Begin is the theme, and yeah, it's gonna be fun. Okay, I thought I had a quote on there. What's your why? We all need a good or great reason why. Yeah, okay, I think I already covered all that. All right, thank you so much for watching. So, rock on, peace out. You guys take care, have a great day, great week, and thank you all for being here. Rock on, peace out. Bye.